Hi all, Mads Barnkop from Kaizer Power Electronics. This video will be about building flight cases, as I do build some pretty large Tesla coils, which are expensive and very time consuming to build. It is also important that you build some proper flight case and storage equipment for that gear. So this will primarily be about using this kind of laminated in situ concrete pouring plate. It's a, as I said, laminated plywood plate, but it's rather cheap because it's made for concrete production of walls and other kinds of construction purposes like that. That also has a few downsides to it, that you won't get plates that are exactly level and they will bend in all kinds of directions, but let's see if we can't overcome that since price is also an issue. So let's dive into building flight cases. Building the large box for my secondary coil, which will be over 1.5 meter long, and also a box for the top load, which will also be, roughly 1.5 times 1.5 meters. So that's some pretty huge cases, and they really do not have to contain that much weight. So I also chose 9mm plates for the sides and 12mm plates for the bottom in order to keep the weight down, because just the sheer size of those boxes will get them way over 20 kilograms just for the box itself. The laminated plywood, as we can see here, had been in terrible storage, so they were skewing in all direction and it was really a pain to get these straightened up. Now when it comes to all the fittings that needs to go on a flight case like this, you can buy these pretty cheap. That's ball corners, that's handles, and that also includes locking mechanisms, which is the regular butterfly twisting lock that you know from so many other flight cases. And all this is actually rather cheap. I was kind of surprised that a handle like this is just about 3 to 4 euro each. And then there's also some more fittings just to finish up corners and do all kind of finish work. A box like this will be kept together with just some thin nails, because it will have aluminum rails all around all the edges, so that will really stiffen up the whole construction and also do not require that much screws into it. It will be riveted together. So just to put the box together, first, I will use these small round nails, and that will basically just go from the edge in here to the middle of the other board. So I'll put the sides together first and then put on the top and the bottom, and then I have a completely closed box that will then be sawn open to get a nice even cut for the lid opening. All sides and lid will be prepared like this. Have all the nails hammered in just to the point getting out on the other side. I made a measure just a half the plate thickness inside with my caliper, and then you just draw a line up along like this, and you get a almost invisible line, as you can see here against the light, but it's just visible enough to actually put your nails in along it, but also invisible enough that you will not notice this once it's put together. And I will even have aluminum rails going in over the edges, so it doesn't really matter. So now let's get all the sides prepared and put the box together. Before putting any sides together, I'll just add a little wood glue. So now there is adding the top and then afterwards the bottom plate. So let's get that going. Building the large flight cases took a bit more effort to get straightened up, as we can see from the plates, that the bigger surface you had, the more it likes to go in all kinds of directions. So in order to stiffen up the whole case construction, I added some 2x1 inch or 40 millimeters regular pine wood on the inside, just to give it a frame around all corners. It's all boxed up now, all six sides put together. And the funny thing about building flight cases, now we're going to saw it in two. To make the cut for the lid, I could use a regular handsaw, but I think I'll choose to use my circular saw, since with a handsaw I would have to make a
mark all around to saw after. But with this, I can just use this distance piece and I get a cut the distance I like. So just be sure to make a cut that does not hit any nails that you have used to put the box together with. And you also need a certain amount of space for the hinge or the locks to actually sit in up here. So I will go down some, I don't know, maybe 10 centimeters, something like that. I'm not going to do that totally precise on this box, as this is just made from leftovers from building the big boxes. This is the saw cam on the circular saw. This is the box we're going to cut up. And here we have it. The box has been cut in half. Looks very nice and even. So as we can see, nice even cut. So we now have a box with a lid. So now we just need to get the aluminum on. When mounting the locking mechanism, it is important that you put the passive part on first, so you have a level against the brackets on the side of the whole case. You take it in, put it in place, get it a level against the two sides here, lock it tight, and then you drill the first hole to keep it in place. You do that with all four locks, and that will keep at a level where we have put the box together. With the boxes all done, there's only one thing left to do, and that is add some nice decals. And I will use my preform here that I made in another video. So if you're interested in how to make your own stencil template, check out that video in the description. Just want a thin layer. And that's good enough to identify your own flight cases. Now you can see I did add a little too much, so it's starting to run, so I will just flip it over. And for the lid as well. And then I will also do the other side of the flight case itself once the first one is dry. Perfect. And here at last, let's just take a look at the two large flight cases, one for the secondary coil here. And see how that is holding up. See, here we have to be a tiny bit careful. In order not to damage the huge secondary coil we have underneath the cloth here. Wow, look at that baby. 40 kilograms of secondary coil. Just the foam itself is around 30 kilograms and around 10 kilograms of copper wire. 1.5 meter in length, resonant frequency,
37 kilohertz. And here at last, and certainly not least, the flight case for the top load. It is 1.6 meters times 1.6 meters. As you can see, it is huge and it takes up a lot of space here in the garage. But it turned out very nice, very well, and supports the ringed toroid in a way that it will never get damaged in transport unless you destroy the whole flight case in itself. So thank you for watching. I hope you now want to build your own flight cases. As you can see, it's not impossible. It's quite cheap compared to buying them. And I hope you will subscribe to the channel, join up for a membership, sign up at highvoltageforum.net if you want to build your own Tesla coils and want to get some help getting started. All I wanted to say is I really want to help you succeed building your own Tesla coils and high voltage equipment. So visit my webpage, visit the forum, and let's help each other make some awesome lightning. So until next time, see ya.